At exactly midday, the funeral service began at the late Nagenda's home in Botansimbi village in Buluwa. This was attended by hundreds of mourners who included political leaders, religious leaders, and officials from the Buganda Kingdom. In attendance was Prime Minister Robina Nabanja, who represented President Museveni as a chief mourner, Works and Transport Minister Jeno Katumba Wamala, Buganda Kingdom Prince David Wasajja, former Vice President Edward Sekandi, among others. The service began with the laying of the wreath on the casket by relatives, friends, and family of the deceased. Engineer John Nasasira, a longtime friend to the deceased, praised the late Nagenda as a determined, honest, and peace-loving person. Felix Osike, the Vision Group Deputy Editor-in-Chief, delivered the condolence message from Vision Group. He eulogized the late Nagenda as a very talented writer who had been a columnist in the New Vision for over a decade.
The readers loved his wit and boldness. Even those who didn't agree with him politically read the column. He attacked all the wrongdoers in government and in opposition equally. He played around with the words to make interesting reading his column. This we shall miss.
Prince David Wasajja, on behalf of the Buganda Kingdom, delivered a message from the King Ronald Muwenda Mutebi.
John, yomu kubatono abatu kiriza ekatara no weyamu wawe. Tunamu jukiranga nyo kulijo.
On behalf of the President, Prime Minister Robina Nabanja eulogized the late Nagenda as a man who worked for the unity of the Buganda Kingdom and the central government. He appealed to his family to keep Nagenda's legacy alive.
Though his early life has come to an end, I urge you to carry on his great work and to continue in the path of his exemplary legacy. May the soul of Mzee Nagenda rest in peace. Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, President of the Republic of Uganda.
The love he had for his country goes beyond unity.
After the speeches, the fallen presidential advisor, John Nagenda, was taken to the hill where he had established his family burial site. Here, he had constructed a shelter under which he willed to be buried. It is in the same shelter that his wife, Ruth Helen Griggs Nagenda, was buried.